Hello and welcome back to Open, everyone. You know, we're always inviting you to get social with us. That's right. Tweet us at BroxNet TV and tweet me too at Rina Valentin. All right. So for years, the New York Youth Symphony has given talented young musicians some of the greatest experiences through its many programs. And the organization creates opportunities for the youth in communities such as the Bronx. They just started this wonderful new residency at Kipp Middle School Academy, which is located in the South Bronx, is seeking and reaching youth between ages 12 to 22. That's here in the Bronx. Sorry, I'm stuck. It's in the Bronx. And it's only because it's a new residency. And of course, you know, they're offering the potential of free tuition opportunities. So, calling all musicians, joining us now to tell us about those opportunities is the New York Youth Symphony Executive Director, Shauna Quill. Hello and welcome to the Bronx.
Thank you. I'm excited to be here. Thanks
welcome
for
you
me.
And the organization itself. I mean, this organization has been in existence before I was born. I can honestly say that.
Yeah, it's, this will be our 56th season this year, and it's been doing really well. It started just as an orchestra back in the 60s, but it's since grown to include a jazz band, chamber music programs, conducting, composition, and this year for the first time, musical theater composition as well. So it's booming. Everything's going super well.
So give us a little background on how it's structured and where it's situated and how one becomes, I guess, qualified to be part of that.
Right. So all the programs have different levels and expectations. So for example, but they're all 12 to 22. And students who are applying to the orchestra, they've probably taken some private lessons. Maybe they've been doing some of the great after school El Sistema programs. This is a great entry point for them, especially the younger kids come in on the string programs, especially for chamber music and the orchestra. The jazz, the average age is about 16 or 17. So it's someone who's been playing in their high school band somewhere, who likes maybe swing music, or they like Frank Sinatra. We mix the old genre of the standard classic jazz with new pieces, because we commission 7 new pieces every year from young composers around the area. So it just depends. And for the new music theater program, this is brand new. So this is someone who likes to sing in their room and maybe wants to learn how to write that down and turn it into something. It's also someone who likes to write a lot of short stories and wants to partner up with someone who could put music to it and create a musical. So this is like a whole new thing we're doing up at Harlem School of the Arts.
Which is great. We had them on a couple of weeks ago, and they're doing really great work.
Oh, yeah.
And it's lovely that you're partnering up with them and that you're here in the Bronx as well. So I want to ask, how well trained or developed does one have to be? Let's say if the program's beginning at 12, how many years should they have been studying prior to auditioning?
I mean, it depends. Everyone learns at a different pace, but I would say on average 3 years for string players. I played the flute. I didn't start till I was 8, so I would not been able to just produce the sound I needed until about 14 or 15. So that's like beginning of high school. So it just depends what the requirements of the instrument are, truly.
And so what kind of demand is this on the individuals taking this on, right? Let's just say somebody's doing it more on a hobby level, or maybe just studying it once a week, now becoming part of the symphony. What kind of commitment does that entail?
Sure, so they rehearse once a week, so it's not hugely time restraining. I think there's more that they do to prep for it. It becomes part of their daily practice that they do probably with their teachers. Maybe they look over the music with them, make sure they know what they're doing. With our chamber music program, they get together independently of our faculty and rehearse together. But I think the thing is, they become such an important part of our community, and the students bond so well. So it doesn't become like a demand on their schedule so much as like, I'm going to see my friends now, see you, Mom. And, you know, they're downtown. The orchestra rehearses at the Domena Center in Hell's Kitchen, and the jazz band rehearses in Times Square. So, I mean, it's just, it's a time for them to get away from the rest of their life and come and be with this community. And a lot, we have a lot of students who in their school, they're that special student and they don't maybe have as many kids like them. And then they come to us and they're like, these are my people, this is amazing. And so they bond forever. Our alumni are still in touch. And actually we had one trustee who was still friends with another trustee, both alums, and he actually got ordained online so he could marry her and be the officiant of his wedding. So, I mean, I think it's just really, it's a lifetime. It's a lifetime commitment.
What did you just started to share? I know. Like, okay, so how is that related to music? But okay, well, it's romantic, right?
Yeah. I guess. Well, I think the thing is, like, music truly becomes something that you stick with forever. And we're not trying to train the next, person playing at Carnegie Hall. There are so many that do. I mean, but we just want people to appreciate and enjoy music and have it last with them a lifetime, whether they're on stage, off stage, backstage, they buy a ticket for something. And truly, I mean, this is my personal opinion too. I feel like we should all consume all the arts. So it, you know, if you learn a classical training, that doesn't mean you don't go play jazz or you don't go play hip hop. Some of my good friends who I went to college with for music are touring with Hamilton right now, you know, or are playing in, actually one's in a rock band, an indie rock band, you know, so it's like, it just, it applies right to everything.
It's beautiful. The idea is the diversity, not only exactly in the music, in the people that you're subjecting yourself to, exactly, right? Because it's a different world.
Yeah, definitely. And I mean, the arts are for everybody. And they help, you know, just the kind of training that you do with, you know, team building and leadership. It's a focus thing, you know, trying to learn a piece. It takes time. And I think that these are life skills you can apply to anything. I do think that, you know, our world, we're very focused on diversity, equity, and inclusion, and we want the arts to be for everybody. So it's one of the reasons we're up at Kipp Middle School Academy now.
Let's talk about that before
sure
we go.
Yeah, sure,
because
sure.
I did mention the possibility of tuition free, which is a big deal because, you know, there's certain types of training that kind of feels exclusive. I mean, honestly.
Well, yeah, so our programs are tuition free. They have a tiny registration fee, which we can actually waive for anyone who needs that. But we also, this year, we have the Vargas Vedder / Yukina Fellowships, which give students $5,000 stipends to pay for all their private lessons or their instrument costs or their subway pass. So we're really trying to go beyond even what our every student gets. We're helping people beyond that. So
is that for the Bronx location?
That's for anyone who applies for it. I mean, we're trying to help people from who just need the help. It doesn't have any restraints. A lot of other fellowships might say, oh, this is for this or for that. You know, we're open. If someone needs the help, that's what we're here for. That's
so how do they go about that? Do they go online? Do they? So if
you go on our website and apply, they can also call me and or email me and just learn more about it. But all the information is also on our website. And then there's a link for an application for scholarship and financial aid and this Vargas Vedder Fellowship.
And then lastly, what does the season look like? Like, when does it start? Right. So that they know when to apply?
Sure. So applications are open, but the auditions don't start for the orchestra. It's the end of August through middle of September. But chamber music, jazz, composition, and conducting, all it's like mid-September to the end of September. So if people sign up now, they can pick their best audition time slot is really the incentive to do it early. And then also because each program has like some specifics about what they need to prepare. So we encourage people to look now. So they have a few weeks to maybe take a look at it, maybe bring it to a teacher and say, can you help me with this? We have a little audition boot camp that we just started. It's just 2 days for people who are new to us, who want some extra coaching. We actually bring them into the room where they'll be auditioning and have a life coach, performance coach, get over their fears. And, you know, so we're trying to help. We're trying to even the playing field.
I want to be 12 again.
I know.
I'm listening to all these wonderful programs. Yeah. Oh, my goodness. Yeah. So thank you so much. And thank you for bringing it here to the Bronx.
Thank you, basically,
they just go to the website and they'll be able to register. And all of this information you just shared with us is online as well.
Yes, absolutely.
Oh, my gosh. Thank you, Shauna.
Thank you so much for
having
me.
Shauna Cole, everyone. You guys, the New York Youth Symphony is now recruiting. Take advantage. They're recruiting youth 12 to 22 to be part of these amazing programs. And once again, for more information, you can visit NYYS.org. Okay, we're taking a quick break, but when we return, we're going to hear about a cultural block party that you don't want to miss.